Hey everybody, what we're going to do now is learn the next part of Man in the Mirror. If you all haven't checked it out already, look on the right under the video description and you can click on how to play the intro. The link to the video that is in the description there. So basically, this is what we're going to learn, the next part here. So basically, just to let you all know, I play from, I got, when I originally recorded this song, you can see here, the book I actually played it from was Songs of the 80s, and it was in here, Man in the Mirror. Now, keep in mind, when I play from sheet music, I just use it as a guide. I don't really follow what's written. I mean, I do, but I don't. I play all from chords, which means basically I'm playing from the melody line, what the singer would sing, what Michael Jackson was singing this, for example, and then I put the guitar chord symbols that are above it, I take those, and I know which notes are in each chord, and then I go from there with it. So it's a lot of improv, but I'm going to show you how I played it. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to play it really, really slow. I'll explain as much as I can as I go along with it, and hopefully it'll all make sense. So the first part here, after we do the intro, you know, the intro we learned in the last video. Okay, next part here is we're just gonna go straight into the verse, G, A. Now here, if you all can reach, I'm doing, this is part of a G chord now, okay? I'm doing a G with my pinky in the left hand, I'm doing a D with my second finger, and a B with my thumb. If you cannot reach that, or if you are not comfortable doing that, do an octave of G, okay? Or just do a single G. You don't have to worry about all those three notes that I'm doing there. It would sound better if you did them, yes, but you don't have to do it, okay? So what I do is here, we have the first part, G, A, then the left hand comes in with that. Now, what I do here is I do a D and a B. Okay? Then I go down to an A there, but the D stays on the bottom the whole time. Octave of F sharp in the left hand. Okay? D and A in the right hand. Okay? Okay, y'all see what I did there? Let me do that again real slow. I went down to an octave of E. Okay, notice D is on the bottom the entire time. Let's do it one more time, nice and slow. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and just play octaves here right now for you guys. Okay, and then again. Goes down to a D in the bass. Down to a C. Okay, so the left hand, G, F sharp, E, D, and then C. Okay, right hand. Okay, that there it is right there. I'm gonna do the right hand again. Okay, I'll do a little bit slower. Okay. Add the left hand in. Okay. Now, if you notice when I play in normal speed, I do a little bit of a fill in there. That again. Okay, I keep messing that up. Let's do it one more time. Right there, okay? What I do is I'm going up, I'm hitting G, C, D, and then G, C, D, and then G up here. That's the first part there. Now, I do apologize, I am making mistakes as I play this. I'm leaving them in the video on purpose because I do teach piano as well. And it is important to know that no matter how good you get, you are always going to make a mistake, okay? But that's how you learn. You learn from your mistakes. So if you make a mistake, don't get frustrated. You keep going with it. You will get it eventually. Even me, I mean, I recorded this song and here I am making mistakes now, and I've been playing this song for a long time now. So, you know, it happens to the best of us. So.